showing my sin, nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know, nothing but the blood of Jesus. Nothing can for sin atone.
Hear the bells ring, hear the angels sing, glory hallelujah to the newborn King. Peace on earth, goodwill to men, Jesus is born in Bethlehem. Hear the bells ring, hear the angels sing, glory hallelujah to the newborn King. Peace on earth, goodwill to men, Jesus is born in a shepherds on the hill, the angels in the sky, baby in a manger, mother's lullaby, wise men from the east, the star that shines so bright, reminds us of the joy of this blessed holy night. Hear the bells ring, hear the angels sing, glory hallelujah to the newborn King. Peace on earth, good will to men, was born in a Bethlehem. Gather at the manger, come and see the baby King. Watch the shepherds running as a host of angels sing. We all can go rejoicing this most holy night. Christ is come among us, love's most radiant light. Hear the bells ring, hear the angels sing, glory hallelujah to the newborn King. Born in a Bethlehem. Hear the bells ring, hear the angels sing, glory hallelujah to the newborn King. Peace on earth, goodwill to men, Jesus is born in a Bethlehem. Jesus is born in a Bethlehem. Jesus is born in a Bethlehem.
He will guide us with his light. will follow in its footsteps on this holy Christmas night.
Glory, glory, hallelujah, oh, the Savior, He is born. Glory, glory, hallelujah, on this blessed Christmas morn. On this blessed Christmas morn. On this blessed Christmas morn.
Good morning, and welcome Peace Church, both here in church and those people listening from home. Pastor Mark is not here this morning, so the Voices in Peace are going to lead us in worship this morning. We have some announcements. We have no anniversaries in our church family this week, but we do have birthdays. So we have Lila Johnson, Katie Plate, Doug Stecker, Lila Hagbarth, Lindoris Jandry, Danielle Vanden Bogard, Janet Stecker, Troy Cummings, Harlan Hartz, Ken Monty, Alyssa Schmelter, Mackenzie Stecker, and Josh Weeding. Happy birthday. Now, we have no Sunday school today. Classes will resume on January 9th. And as a reminder, there are cradle roll gifts out on the narthex table next to the envelopes. And if you're willing, we need some ushers for January. So please let June Blue know if you can help usher in January. And we have an announcement about the offerings for 2021 need to be received by the church by New Year's Eve. So get them in before Friday. And the envelopes are also out there. And the Secret Pal program is starting up again, which is a joy to quite a few of us. So if you want to be a Secret Pal, let Sandy Myers or Jean Hoyer know. And we'll start that up again. So let's start this morning in prayer. Good morning, Lord. It is so good to be gathered here to worship you and thank you for the many blessings and grace that you have given us. We also bring our worries and concerns to lay at your feet. May we know your guidance and wisdom to make good decisions. 24/7, Lord, we need you. Amen. Go ahead and stand.
I'd love to tell the story of Christ the newborn King, sleeping in a manger while hosts of heaven sing, of shepherds on the hillside rejoicing in the song. This day is born the Savior, we've waited for so long. I love to tell the story of Jesus and His glory, proclaim the wondrous story of God's great gift of love. I love to tell the story of Christ the newborn King, of how we came from heaven, His gifts of love to bring, so we could be His children and ever proclaim the wonders of His glory and power.
I believe in God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only begotten Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the one holy universal Christian church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Far in the fields of Bethlehem, shepherds were keeping their watch. Suddenly the heavenly host appeared. Alleluia, alleluia. Shepherds fear not, for the news that we bring shall be to you a great joy. A child is born in Bethlehem. Alleluia, alleluia.
Talk to the grown-ups about gifts and how we should use them. Now, what's in this basket? Fruit snacks. And every week, Pastor Mark gives you fruit snacks because he loves you. He loves you like Jesus does, and he gives you a gift.
Sometimes you get a candy and fruit snacks.
Candy and fruit snacks, okay. out of the mouth of babes. All right. So today we're going to do something special. I'm going to talk about sharing gifts. So today I'm going to give you two. And one of them you can keep and eat, but the other one you should give to somebody else as a gift. So that's sharing is caring. Yep, your sister. Your sister's sick, so you're going to take one home for her?
Yeah.
Okay. So we're going to do sharing is caring. Can you say that? Very good.
I always say that.
Okay. So we're going to close our hands and we're going to pray. Dear Jesus, help us to be good. Help us to share our gifts and our toys. And we know that you're happy when we do nice things for each other. Amen. Now that Christmas Day has passed and all the giving and receiving of gifts is just about done, we have to think about what we're going to do with our gifts. Are we going to share them? Use them wisely? Sparingly? Re-gift them? Or maybe some you just toss or forget all about? The whole idea behind giving gifts at Christmas dates back to the birth of Jesus. When the wise men saw the stars shining brightly, they packed up their best to give to the baby, their Savior, the future King, the Messiah. Time and commercialism may have eroded that true meaning of gift giving, but it's not too late to refocus on your life towards God. We'll start with Matthew 2:11. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed and worshiped him. They opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. This one verse just filled my mind with questions, and I realized it was suggestions for a life of dedication, respect, and adoration to Jesus. In researching the gifts, I discovered the symbolism of what these gifts represent, of who and what Jesus is to all of us. The Magi brought the expensive gifts and treasured gifts as recognition and worship to Jesus for who he is, was, and will forever be. They truly worshiped and adored Jesus. The first gift was gold. Gold is a gift reserved for royalty. Gold is beautiful, valuable, and long-lasting. It is a symbol not only of worth, but also of knowledge, wisdom, and faith. Gold was presented as a gift to the king, the leader, the head of our faith. Frankincense was the second gift, and it's an incense reserved for worshiping his deity, the creator, supreme being, someone with divine status. His purity, holiness, and righteousness are being honored. Because it is so fragrant when burnt, it was also used as a religious offering. This represents God's ultimate sacrifice for us. Lastly, they gave myrrh. And myrrh is a spice that's often mixed with oil to anoint the prophets, but is also used at the time of death and mourning. This is what the Marys may have been carrying to the tomb that glorious day when they discovered that the stone was rolled away and Christ had risen. We can't celebrate Easter without first celebrating the birth of Christ. The Magi brought these expensive and treasured gifts as recognition, adoration, and worship. They gave Jesus the best that they had. Now, gift by definition is a present, a sacrifice given at no cost to the receiver. Eternal life is a gift from God. It is a free gift, not something we earn or something that we have to pay back. To accept this gift, you need to work towards a Christ-centered way of life. This is a gift that's forever in glory with God. The Christ-centered life are the choices that we make. They're not always easy, not always popular, and certainly not comfortable. But as you make these choices, you realize that as soon as they come from your heart, they are pleasing to God. God also gave each of us talents, strengths, and abilities. We honor him by using these gifts to glorify his name. We all have something to give, to use, or to share. Not everyone has the same gift, but together, all of our gifts mesh into something beautiful and amazing. We'll now go over to Romans 12, 4 through 8, where Paul tells us, "For just as each of us have one body with many members, and these members do not all have the same function, so in Christ we, though many, form one body, and teach each member, and each member belongs to all of the others. We have different gifts according to the grace given to each of us. If your gift is prophesying, then prophesy in accordance with your faith. If it is serving, then serve. If it is teaching, then teach. If it is to encourage, then give encouragement. If it is giving, then give graciously, generously. And if it is to lead, do it diligently. And if it is to show mercy, do it cheerfully." We'll break these down a little bit. If your gift is prophesying, then prophesy in accordance with your faith. Prophesying isn't always predicting the future. It often means preaching God's messages. Are you bold enough to explain what is expected? Do you have enough confidence in your faith to tell others about it? Now, Pastor Mark is in a league all his own when it comes to preaching, but you and I can still tell the story of what Christ's love has done for us. If it is serving, then serve. Are you willing to serve others? Do you put others' needs ahead of your own? Are you humble enough to help others feel comfortable, secure, or fed? Does that overwhelmed, exhausted feeling on the Sunday after Gospel Fest feel good? We all know we can't convert anyone, but we can give them a venue to make their own personal choice to accept Christ. We serve God by serving others. Serving can be as simple as being on a committee or volunteering to help with a special project, but it can also be intense and overwhelming, as people in the medical field can attest to lately. Then we'll move on to, if it is teaching, then teach. Do you understand the Bible stories? Can you help others understand them? Can you understand the lesson, the life pattern, or the choices we need to make? Do you enjoy teaching Sunday school, or helping with VBS, or leading a Bible study? Do you actually talk to your kids about God and Jesus? Do your grandkids know that you love Jesus? These are all little things that we can do. If it is to encourage, then give encouragement. Do you have that knack for motivating people? Can you help them want to take the next step? And do they know that you will be there for them if they make that next step and fail? That's supporting and encouraging someone. Do you celebrate a child's progress in music lessons? Now, I'm just saying there's this huge difference between sixth grade band practice and listening to them again as seniors in high school band. That big difference is because somebody encouraged them to keep going. A simple act of sending a card to someone or sending a smile in the mail to someone encourages somebody on their weakest days. Just call and check on them. Let them know that you're thinking about them. And we move on to giving. If it is giving, then give generously. Are you generous with your time or your money? Do you give or help someone without the need for acknowledgement or accolades? Now, does it really pain you to put something in a church envelope? Or do you give it from your heart and just financially support the church because you know that's right? Are you able to clean up someone's yard, give them a ride to the store or a doctor's appointment? How many of you have ever paid it forward? That's giving. If it is to lead, do it diligently. Most leaders are natural organizers or managers. These skills can be taught or learned, but some people just have it. Now, at the annual meetings, you might notice that most people who have served 6 years proclaim that they have been changed by serving. If for no other reason, they have a respect for the behind-the-scenes stuff that needs to happen to make the church work. It isn't one person, but a teamwork. Team all working together. And there are different gifts that they bring to the table, help make everything function nicely. And then we go on. If it is to show mercy, do you do it cheerfully? Can you give compassion, forgiveness, a little leniency? Are you patient with someone's quirks? Or that gentleman in the checkout line that shakes and fumbles with his wallet because his hand shakes so bad? Do you give someone a second chance or the benefit of the doubt? Can you let somebody butt in line without going all Karen on them? Do you generally see the positives rather than dwelling on the negatives? Can you actually forgive and forget? So obviously we cannot all have all of the gifts, but we need to acknowledge that they're all important. It takes all kinds to make a world, and even more so to make a church family function as a whole, as an inviting group of believers. There are so many more gifts that people share by using. Here at Peace Church, we enjoy the talents of many that have talents in music, and the ability to fix things, the financial reporting, those that are technically savvy, you got my thumbs up on that one, and of course, common sense. We are blessed that other people's gifts balance out our weaknesses. Together we work for the greater whole. The best gifts are not bought, but heartfelt acts that we share with those we love. The giving can be seen by others as a testimony of us living as Jesus wants us to live, together, for, and with each other. Just as the wise men gave their time, treasures, and talents, so should we give. But there is one more T, and that's testimony. Be ready to share your testimony. When we share our stories of all that Christ has done for us, his love, his faithfulness, his forgiveness, and all the gifts that he has given us, then we are adoring him. Just as the wise men came to adore him, just as the little drummer boy played his best for him, we too need to use our time, treasures, and talents to honor him. The Magi brought these expensive and treasured gifts as recognition and worship. They gave Jesus the best that they had. What are we? What are you? What am I willing to give back to Jesus as a way to honor and adore him? Amen.
When Christ was born, in Bethlehem, manger, when angel hosts brought tidings from on high, the shepherds gave in fear and awesome wonder, while songs of joy were wafted from the sky. All in vain. will find him in a manger. Go tell the world of God's salvation plan.
Go tell the news of the blessed gospel news. A Savior lives, a King is born. Tell the news, the blessed gospel news. Oh, praise his name, our King is born.
And shepherds came and bowed in humble worship, while angel hosts were hovering very near. The world slept on, but in a lonely stable, hope overcame and love cast out all fear.
Go tell the news, the blessed gospel news. Our King is born. Go tell the news, the blessed gospel news. Oh, praise his name, our King is born.
Lord, we bring you the joys and concerns that are heavy on our hearts. We especially raise up Matt Gale and Dennis Dougal, who are sick. I want to raise up those with medical tests or treatments in the near future. Please bless those that are working over the holidays, be it military, medical, or the retail workers. Bless their lives. We ask for traveling mercies for everyone that go about in the bustle of the holidays. We pray for the lowly old and the lonely young. May they feel loved and at peace. Please guide them and wrap your arms around them. Please hear our prayers as we join our voices in the words that our Savior taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us those trusts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. We'll invite the ushers to come forward to collect the offering this morning.
Came to see this child. They walked.
Jesus grew into a man. He died for you and me. But in 3 days he rose again. With us he'll ever be. Amazing grace, how sweet.
Let us leave with a word of encouragement. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice. Peace and joy to all of you. May the Lord's love shine through each of you this coming week. Use your gift to glorify his name. Amen.
Amen.
What can wash away my sin? nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Nothing can for sin atone. Nothing but the blood of